On a busy street in the heart of Cambodia's capital, Phnom Penh, sits a housing complex known as the White Building. This cubist four-story structure got its name from its once bright facade. Today it is crumbling, its walls darkened by years of punishing tropical weather. Inside its long hallways and open stairwells, you find a city within a city, with shops, apartments, and social areas. It was built in the 1960s as low-income housing. Today, nearly 500 families live and work here, spanning several generations. Opera singer Kut Chom Peep has lived most of his 43 years here. He says a vibrant artistic community grew out of the ashes of the Communist Khmer Rouge regime's brutal rule in the 1970s.
In 1979, after liberation from the Khmer Rouge, the Minister of Culture gathered all the surviving artists in Cambodia to live here. I moved here in 1980. There are artists of all kinds, such as dancers, singers, musicians, even circus performers. The woman living next to me is a ballet dancer.
Before going on to sing for his country's king, Kut Chom Peep found a fertile ground for his training here.
In daily life here, the younger generation who are talented in the arts could improve their skills. When I lived surrounded by artists, I naturally could develop myself to be able to sing, as we all share with each other.
Today, the Aziza School continues that tradition, offering local residents a space for music classes. Students can also take English or computer lessons in their small ground floor classroom. Attracted by the unique community, other people moved in over the years, from doctors to lawyers to government workers. But time is now running out for the White Building. Without regular maintenance, it has become increasingly dangerous. Some stairwells are no longer safe to walk on. A large fire several years ago further undermined the structure. Local government representative and White Building resident Nem Sovan says basic repairs, like a new roof, are too expensive.
Whenever the rain falls, water penetrates parts of the building. It's difficult for residents to renovate because they do not have the means. And because it's a collective space, one just expects others to repair the broken parts. So it's really difficult.
Rather than attempting to refurbish, officials are now planning to tear the White Building down. They say their motivation is the residents' safety. But it is undeniable this location is one of the best in the entire city. From the roof, you can see new buildings or construction in every direction. A Japanese investor has the go-ahead from the government to begin an $80 million rebuild to become luxury apartments. Cambodia has a bad reputation for forcibly evicting people to make room for new development. Activists estimate 770,000 people have been victims of land grabs. But government officials say they are committed to a fair outcome for the White Building and are negotiating with residents like Kut Chom Peep.
They've invited the people, artists, and civil servants living in the White Building to join a number of meetings to discuss a resolution for whether we want cash or housing. They will knock down the entire White Building and build a 21-story condominium and let people here live from the fourth floor to the eighth floor. The first four floors will be a parking garage, and they will sell the units from the ninth floor up to the 21st floor.
Residents will have to move somewhere else for up to 4 years during the renovation, or accept a substantial one-time cash payment of $130 per square foot, but leave the White Building for good. So far, 80% say they will take the cash offer. In a city where land rights activists say some 10% of the population has been evicted for similar development projects, this is a notable outcome. With the deadline of July 15th looming, Kut Chom Peep is torn. He says no matter what, they will mourn what will be lost here.
It doesn't matter how far I travel. I still think of this place because I feel happy to live here. Even if there's a big house for me, I'll still miss this place because I grew up here.